Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. So today we're going to be talking about a voice changing tool for OBS. It's called Voice AI and it'll allow you to change your voice to quite a few different options. So you've got two options. Basically, it's a record mode and a live mode. So we'll be going over all of those. There are a few things to consider. So definitely stick around and get through some of the more nitty gritty stuff. But it's something pretty cool, and I guess it's going to get better with time. So we'll jump straight into it. Once you've downloaded it, I'll leave a link in the description. The first thing you want to do is tune your voice. So go to settings, go to voice tuning, and then jump through the steps. So it'll ask you to record 3 seconds of silence first, and then it'll ask you to record some voice samples, which you just do normally. I'll leave a little example up on the screen here of me going through it. The long journey home took a year, Alan's second guest traveling to Mars. She called his name many times, but Kamala could not get Joe's attention. She saw a cat in the neighbor's house. A gold ring will please most any girl or hobbit. A pink shell was found on the sandy beach. The grass and bushes were wet with dew. The blind man counted his old coins. A severe storm tore down the barn. When you hear the bell, come quickly. Okay, we're done. We've recorded some voices. Okay, so once you've set everything up and you're going to choose your two options here. So you've got record mode. So make sure you set up your microphone here. So just select it from the list. I'm going to be using this one. Then jump over to the center here. So here's the list of voices. Some of them are better than others. You can go by the rating. We will select one now. Let's try and pick something with a decent rating. This one seems pretty good, pretty stereotypical, but we'll give it a go. Then we'll click train. It's going to use some credits. We're on the free version, so we've got one attempt at this.
This is a standardized audio sample to demonstrate voice stability and tone without any voice acting. For optimal results, try doing your best impression.
Okay, so that's the sample. We're going to attempt to use that voice that's trained on our sample at the moment. Just here, you can see it training through on the sample we recorded earlier. So we will see what sort of results we get. It does take a little time to train it, so just wait. Okay, we are finished and we're going to attempt to use it. Okay, so now we have our system set up. So we're going to basically start recording. Voice set, click to record. Okay, we're now currently using the Joe Biden voice recording and we're going to see what it sounds like.
We are now currently using the Joe Biden voice recording and we're going to see what it sounds like.
Pretty average, to be honest, but I didn't actually try. Started off really good, then faded off, so let's do a test of this voice to see how well it sounds. In previous attempts, I've found my Australian accent doesn't convert well to the American accent of Joe Biden in this recording.
Let's do a test of this voice to see how well it sounds. In the previous attempt, I found my Australian accent didn't convert well to the American accent of Joe Biden.
Okay, so that was a bit better. I found talking slower, and I guess probably trying an American accent would have worked better. That's basically the gist of it. So you can go in and choose whatever. You can create your own voices. You can clone your own voices as well. We've got a couple of options trained here. So let's try one more. Let's try this one. Okay, we're going to try another generic voice sample of a politician and see what it sounds like. Remember, we have a 15-second limit on the free trial.
Okay, we're going to try another generic voice sample of a politician and see what it sounds like. Remember, we have a 15-second limit on the free trial.
Still not great, but again, it's not too bad. If you're just fooling around with this stuff for some sort of hilarious YouTube videos or whatever, it's not too bad. Okay, so the next option here is if you want to use live mode. So if you switch to live, there's a couple of things you need to make sure of. So you need to set your voice again. We'll set that voice. You can do a little test if you want to hear yourself. But the most important thing here is if you are using OBS, you need to go over and make some settings changes. So we'll just drag OBS across to this screen. Okay, so just ignore the top half of the screen here. It's one of the problems with recording OBS. It just sort of has an infinite mirror design. So now we're in OBS. We're going to go to settings. Here, you need to change to audio, and you need to make sure your microphone is set to the Voice AI audio cable, just like this. So once you've done that, click apply, then okay. And the next important thing here to do is make sure you have your audio input capture set. So if you have this here set as something different, so we'll just go in and check mine. It says properties. I'm using this microphone here. So you will need to change this to the voice AI one to get this to work. However, I suggest if you want more than one voice, you're going to want to set up sources and you're going to want to hotkey them. So I have the normal microphone here that I'm using now, and I have voice AI set up, and I can just toggle this on and off. So if I go into this, go to properties, you'll see it's set to voice AI. Now, one more thing else I will add here is that you probably want to add your same filters and microphone settings from your primary one to the voice AI one. I find it gives a better result, but you can experiment with this yourself. So to do that, just create your voice AI one, set it up with the correct microphone, then right click on your primary one and go copy filters, and then go across and then paste your filters across to the voice AI one. This will give you a better result. Experiment with this. It'll depend on how you've got your voice filters set up, but I definitely suggest doing this. It makes a big difference. Okay, so now that you have everything set up in OBS, the next most important thing is to make sure you know what you're doing in live mode. So if you're going to be streaming to Twitch, YouTube, or any of the other live platforms, something important to consider here. Once you've got your voice set up, your microphone selected, you've got a slider here for faster and better. So having it set to faster is going to be what you need for streaming live, because you won't have an audio video delay. The further you slide this way, the bigger the delay will be. So you will have a major audio and video out of sync here. So your mouth will be moving in the video and your audio will be totally out of sync. So if you're going to be streaming live, you've essentially got to have it maxed out on the faster side, so the delay is absolutely minimal. Some people get around this by wearing a mask or something, so you can't actually see your mouth moving and notice the out of sync. But that isn't exactly ideal either. So just keep that in mind. I personally find this little voice AI app best working in record mode. The live mode's pretty hit and miss, but I suspect in time the process will get better and faster, as will the voice quality. So might be something to think about in the future, if not currently now. Okay, so I think that pretty much wraps up this little voice AI tutorial for Discord. You can do similar with any other app. So there's a list of things here. It all comes down to the configuration you have inside. So we just done OBS. Discord will be similar. Skype, similar. WhatsApp, Steam, whatever. You've probably got a pretty good understanding of those apps anyway. So just switch over to voice AI for your microphone and you're good to go. If you're into this sort of AI stuff, we've got quite a few videos coming up, and we've done a few recently for Adobe Firefly and two of the options in there. So they've finally got a text-to-image creator and a pretty fancy text effect creator. So if you're into typography, it's definitely something to check out. So if you haven't heard of Adobe Firefly yet, it's basically a Midjourney and a Stable Diffusion competitor. And from the get-go, from the beta, it's actually pretty good. So definitely check it out. And those videos will be linked in the description as well. Anyway, that wraps up this guide. Hope you found it useful. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on another video. Cheers, everyone.